Hey guys,
this is Janice
and I'm Sonia
and we are Jayesslee.
We are currently in Singapore at the moment and we just wanted to let you guys know that we're coming to Washington DC for the first time in our lives to see Abraham Lincoln
and
President Obama.
Just kidding, we are coming to see you guys.
Guys, we're gonna be there for the Fresh Freedom Concert.
What is this all about? Can you tell me?
I can. So basically, the Freedom Fresh concert is bringing awareness to all of these people about the crisis in North Korea and how we can inspire them to help us with the cause. Because there's so many people in North Korea that there are all these orphans living outside and without papers or anything. They can't be adopted and they're being persecuted. And the bill that we're trying to pass would allow, let's say, American citizens to adopt them and go through a faster process than, let's say, waiting like a year and a half to get them.
Wow. So, okay, what can I do to help?
You can, well, by performing at this concert, you're helping us, of course. And if any of you are interested in volunteering or anything, we have a Facebook page as well that you can like. It is the Korean Church Coalition, KCC, it's written up there.
Yep.
And also we have a website, and if you guys want to check us out, there's all the contact information there, and you can contact us there.
Awesome. Can we get you 10 round of applause? And then straight after the Jayesslee and like it. Okay. We're definitely checking that out. Yeah. So this is a great cause. We're such an honor to be part of it. It's seriously, let's just do whatever we can to be part of this amazing movement. Yeah. Guys, are you doing alright?
Yeah!
Okay, cool. For those of you who aren't doing alright, let's just loosen up a little bit.
To all my people, holding down the block for the gospel like Apostle Paul, I am pleased to hear about your strong faith like the folks in Ephesians. May the Father give you grace and peace and bestow an overflow of understanding for the hope he gives the man. It is amazing to see the body of Christ unite to stand together for God's commandments. So keep fighting the good fight despite the violence that might have been from the cunning Leviathan. I speak of 1 Peter 1:6-7, cause ahead of us there's a wonderful joy in heaven. It delighted the Father to adopt us into his family, now we can call him Abba.
Thank you, Father.
Thank God for the guarantee he made when he sent us the third eternal person of the Trinity.
We are your church and you are our God.
For dreaming, I'm reaching the heavenly. He's richer than Beverly. Holy Spirit, my
Ephesians
guarantee.
1:13-14.
Meet the Lord, raise the face. Thank the Father,
who is grace.
Since the Lord,
save my place.
Finish running
in his race.
In his kingdom, and reaping the benefits of seeking his relevance, concealing the venomous, the healing the many sins through Jesus, who's heaven sent. So I praise him all my life, but glorifying intent. And I plan to see my brothers and sisters reach out and preach from the scriptures so they can see the great picture.
So you can see
Jesus died so we can share in his kingdom. And him from sin, we have freedom. I hope you see that you need him.
We have victory.
Jesus, pour out the Spirit, the Holy Counselor, counsel us to be. Counselors, counsel the needed for your word, so we can usher our sisters and brothers, lead them to a place like the weather, your heavenly realms forever dwell.
We are your church and you are our guide. We will give you all our praise. And as our lives, they slowly come to an end, as your church together will sing.
Check it.
My brothers, my sisters, everyone I know, remember the last thing that Jesus said was go, go. Make disciples of all in every nation. We've been commissioned to spread this salvation.
You're the God of this city. You're the King of these people. You're the Lord of this nation. You are. You're the light in this darkness. You're the hope to the hopeless. You're the peace to the restless. You are. There is no one like our God. There is no one like our God. For greater things have yet to come, and greater things are still to be done in this city.
Gentlemen, there have been profound changes on the Korean Peninsula since I last addressed you two hot summers ago. North Korean women seeking a better life, seeking religious liberty, seeking freedom for themselves and their families should never be used as property policy.
I must tell you, your work here today is very, very important. I applaud you for it. I urge you to redouble your efforts. And hopefully, just as we saw in Eastern Europe, once information began to get in, and once the NGO groups began to really speak out, the world began to change. Appeal to your friends to join you. Thank you so much for what
you do. I'm Congressman Dana Rohrabacher from Orange County, but what's most important, I'm Congressman Dana Rohrabacher from the United States of America, and today we declare our solidarity with the repressed people of North Korea. They too will be free.
New Jersey boasts one of the largest Korean American populations in the United States. And I'm proud to represent many of them in northern New Jersey. As United States and the Republic of Korea cooperate to ensure security and relieve political tension on the Korean Peninsula, we cannot ignore the humanitarian crisis in North Korea.
If I don't have a voice, you need to be the voice. Shout for freedom. Let's hear it. Let them hear you in North Korea. Let them hear you in North Korea. Let them hear you in China. Our message to North Korea, let those people go. Our message to China, when they go, treat them with dignity. Treat them with devotion. Do not treat them with despair. Thank you, and God bless you for your work.
When it comes to freedom, freedom does not come easy. Freedom comes from standing in the sun when it's triple digits in Washington, D.C. Freedom comes from writing down your story when it's painful to tell your story, to make sure that everyone knows your story. A voice for the voiceless never happens by accident. It happens by folks who invest day after day, week after week, year after year. And we will be back with you here next year, if that's what it takes, the year after that, and the year after that, and the year after that, one family at a time, folks, will be
first,
free.
First, my role as the ranking member of the Intelligence Committee, we deal with a lot of issues, national security and issues involving North Korea. Need. Another issue, the thousands of North Korean children who have fled to neighboring countries, such as Mongolia, Thailand, and other Southeast Asian countries. Those orphans are at constant risk of human trafficking, sexual exploitation, or being sent back to North Korea.
But now we have, I understand, 20,000 of these young people as orphans in China. And I'm very pleased to be a co-sponsor of H.R. 1464. We need to do everything we can to find homes for these people. There are way more than 20,000 families in this country who would like to adopt a Korean orphan. Thank you very, very much for helping us make this happen. Thank you very much.
Faith and love, God's given.
To live as friends. Bye.